In this video, I'm going to show you how I created an animation for my Stream Deck.
Check out this video I did with my Stream Deck and let me know if you can match the colors with the music. When I got it, that's literally the first idea that I thought of. So check out this video I did with my Stream Deck and let me know if you can match the colors.
Hey, what's up y'all? My name is Relly and welcome back to another episode of How You Do That, where I explain how I created something that I posted on social media. It's never the right way how to do it, but it's how I did it. First, if you have no idea what a Stream Deck is, you can go and watch my other video explaining what it is and how I use it for editing and not gaming or streaming. Anyway, this edit was fairly simple. In fact, it was a little too simple because I did something that I normally don't do, which is use an After Effects template. Yeah. But the good thing is this template actually helped me speed up the process because I would have to do a bunch of math and it would have taken a lot of time to figure it out. I could have done it, but I was like, if it's already done, might as well do it. And I personally like to like reverse engineer templates, like pick them apart and figure out like why this is doing this, or if there's an expression, or if it's a Premiere Pro template, figure out how to do this effect on my own eventually. So templates aren't always a bad thing. Here's where I got this template from. I suggest watching this video and grabbing all of the needed links from this video. The link to this video is actually in my description below, but the basic outline of this edit is going to be: figure out what you want your animation to be, place it in the correct composition, export each key, convert to a GIF or GIF, and put them on your Stream Deck. So when you download and unzip the template file, it will look like this. There are two main compositions that I dealt with: the 15 key spacing guide and the 15 key wallpaper. If you have a Stream Deck XL, then you would use the 32 key compositions. The first thing I did was go in the wallpaper composition and remove the placeholder graphic. I then added the music that I wanted to sync the animation to. I created quick animations like a quick scale up that I thought out all on my sticky note storyboard outline, and my wallpaper composition looked like this. But what I did was I went back to the spacing composition and I figured out where the spacing was. So I brought up the ruler by pressing Command R or Control R, and I figured out where on the ruler where it was, and then I went back to the wallpaper and just brought the ruler to that exact same spot or relatively the same area. That way, when I did something like create a mask for a specific key, I could easily tell where the edge of that key was. After I completed my animation, I checked it out on the spacing guide composition and then opened the 15 key Stream Deck tiles folder and added each key to the render queue. After they exported, I used the GIF or GIF converter that was in the description of the video that I mentioned earlier. It doesn't have to be that one, but it obviously worked for him, so why not use it? After I converted, downloaded, and renamed each key that was now a GIF or GIF, I placed it in the Stream Deck through the app. Once that was finished, I filmed the Stream Deck with a looped intro and outro. I pressed the hotkey that led to the animation and recorded the entire animation. When you play the animation, it won't be in real time, so I had to make a few adjustments in Premiere Pro. Primarily, all I had to do was just really adjust the speed at various parts, and eventually the timing worked out. It might take you a little while, but eventually you'll get it. So that, my friends, is how I did that. If you have extra time, I suggest throwing an animation on your Stream Deck, especially if it's at a specific time that you're not using it. You can even use a video and have it just play in the background if you want to. If you have any questions or anything, feel free to comment down below. And thank you for watching this video. I really do appreciate it. Don't forget to thumbs up bell, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.